And I wanted to ask you about, like, because you've worked with Mike for such a long time and you've been in so many of his films, is there an element where you're actually having to sort of contend with people's expectations that it's a Mike Lee film and you want to kind of reach a new audience as well, obviously?
Well, that's interesting. I've not thought of that, really. I don't kind of think in that way.
Is it a difficult decision for you? I mean, does Mike call you up and say, I've got this project, and you're like, I'm in, you know?
That's it, and that's all it is. There's nothing he can tell you about it, because it doesn't exist. Mary didn't exist, you know, he can't tell you, because she doesn't exist until we create her.
Yeah.
No, it is literally that. He just rings up and says, look, I'm going to do this film. Do you want to be in it? I mean, he'll give you an idea of how long he's going to book you for, and then therefore you know kind of what your involvement in the film is going to be. I mean, obviously, like, for example, Jim Broadbent and I were both in Vera Drake, but just cameos.
Yeah.
So obviously we weren't booked for 9 months to do that. You know, we were just on that for a month or something. But this, no, I mean, you know, he rang me up and he said, do you want to be in my film?
You're like, okay.
Okay.
Not busy, I'm in.
It's not a difficult decision. Because you know that the work is going to be so fulfilling.
So you must be very proud when you see a character as powerful and strong as Mary.
Yeah, no, I mean, I'm really, I mean, I happen to think Another Year is a really excellent film, and I'm not being biased because obviously I've done lots of his films, but I think it's really wonderful, and that I think there's a maturity about him as a filmmaker. Of course there is. He's 67, but you know, it's just, you can see this fantastic artist just getting better.
Mm.
And, you know, and I'm getting better too, because you just do as you get older. If you walk around without the blinkers on and are still open to observing the world around you and all of that stuff and understanding the human condition, and you've had so many more experiences yourself.
Mary wouldn't say that though, would she? She'd say something quite opposite to that, I would imagine, if she was sitting here. She'd be like, you know, life has battered me, and sometimes she feels like a victim, and sometimes circumstances.
Yeah.
Do you find it hard to get into that kind of mindset? Did you draw on people that you know to help?
You draw on all sorts of things. I mean, it's no one person or two people. It's a, you know, it's a cocktail of people bits that I know. It might be, there might be somebody in there that you just see at the bus stop that morning or something. You know, it's.
But you don't have your friends going, that was a little.
No.
Bit
oh no, because it isn't that.
No.
You know, it absolutely is not any sort of impersonation on that level at all. But, you know, there are a lot of people, not just women, who are lonely like Mary. And then you put into that mix the fact that she's, you know, she tries to cover up that loneliness. Mm. There's this huge mask that for most of the film you see her wearing. And it's all, you know, she says, oh, I'm a glass half full kind of person. Mm. And she's trying to be. She's trying to eke out a life for herself that's full. But what she lacks and what she's painfully hungry for is love and affection and tactile, touching relationship, you know.
Engagement with somebody else as well. She does feel like someone that's sort of the end of their strength almost.
Well, I think you see her at the end of the film, sort of at the end of her strength, really.
You first met Mike in 1979, I read.
Yes,
and he got you improvising.
Well, he got me to work on a project with him, and we did the normal process, which does involve at some point improvising, and I just loved it, and it kind of changed my whole thinking about myself as an actress, definitely.
How has he changed? Has he mellowed? Because there's a lot of journalists are like, well, it's a bit, you know, a little intimidating to talk to.
I think so, and I'm sorry that some of you and your colleagues experience that with him, because it's not like that in the rehearsal room. He just loves the bit with all the actors and the crew and the shooting, and we really do have a really good time. I mean, he it's almost a prerequisite that he just absolutely couldn't work with somebody who didn't have a sense of humour. And, you know, for all the kind of depths that you go to, especially playing somebody like Mary, who's got a real sad, dark side, you know, there's a lot of laughs.